Two will advance. Two will hope to move up in qualifying. Cash and points from the folks at Mission Foods on the line. Too fast, too tasty. Red light, Greg Anderson. Oh, man. He dropped the hammer just a little too soon. 661 for Jerry Don Tucker. Hello. He's going to get the number one qualifying spot, but guess what? He's not going to advance. Look at the lights. Jeg goes 662 at 206. Got there first. 664 for Troy. Got there second. Jerry Don Tucker had an 057 light, and that cost him. Four of them get off the starting line, clean into the finish line. It's going to be Doug Kalitta. How about 3.73? Look at the speed, 336 miles an hour. Doug Kalitta takes Mac Tools back to the top and takes him into the final round. Tony Stewart, 3.807 at 324. He's going to advance. Two of them get to come back and run for the money. Oh, yeah, and those pointers points come in handy at the end of the year. You never have too many points at the end of the year. Another great quad, and it's going to be lanes 3 and 4 that advance. 394, Paul Lee, advance. 397, Blake Alexander, advance. All four of them get cleanly off the starting line. Reaction advantage goes to Troy Coughlin Jr. Win light goes. How about Jeg Coughlin, 662 to win it? By 0.008 of a second. TJ's going to finish second, 664.
As Angel Sampay puts the medallion around Jeg Coughlin's neck, the winner of the Mission Foods Too Fast, Too Tasty Challenge. Jeg, this is your first one, probably the only box you haven't checked off, and now you've got that under wraps. What is it like to come out and race here, and race during qualifying, and beat your nephew?
It feels great, honestly. You know, to be competitive, you know, during qualifying is a new thing for us. Obviously, thanks to Mission for all the work they put together, not only for the Too Fast, Too Tasty, but obviously for the NHRA series. So, you know, it feels great to get a win here on Saturday without question. You know, I think we ended up number two or three in the field. I didn't hear where that ended up after this session, but I'm ready for tomorrow, so let's go.
Wilkerson up on the center line. He's off the throttle, and how about it? 391, 326. Austin Prock picks up the Too Fast, Too Tasty win. 393 for Paul Lee. Another great run for Paul. They continue to improve. 396 for Blake Alexander and Dan Wilkerson. That car was pushing over towards the center line, spun the tires, kicked the tail. He was out of the throttle to a 435. Austin Prock gets the win.
And here comes the medallion from Angel Sampay, the brand ambassador for Mission Foods, as Austin Prock finishes the day holding the trophy here for Mission Foods. What's it like to get that win on qualifying day?
It's awesome. I love, you know, having a chance to race on Saturday and earning these crew guys some cash, man. They just work so hard and are doing such a great job. Thank you, Mission Foods, for all you do for the NHRA. We really appreciate it.
We've got a hat change for you because you are the number one qualifier, rocking the yellow hat as we go into race day tomorrow. Conditions going to be better than we saw all weekend. What can we expect from your team?
I think you're going to see some really good runs. You'll probably see low ET of the weekend first round from one of these cars. But to be 1-2 with my boss, John Force, we got some bad hot rods here at John Force Racing right now, and we're having a blast.
The first ever 4-wide, Too Fast, Too Tasty champion in Top Fuel will be decided 3.7 seconds from now. It's going to be Antron Brown, 379, 330 miles an hour. Also, 379, Shawn Langdon. But his car, only 305. Tony goes 382 at 325 miles an hour. Doug had the haze off the Goodyears out there about 400 feet, and he slows to a 490. Antron Brown, those guys need a little pick-me-up.
Welcome back to the 4-Wide Nationals here in Las Vegas. As brand ambassador for Mission Foods, Angel Sampay puts a medallion around Antron Brown's neck. Antron Brown, you won this race last year. Now you've got the first step of it, I guess, so to speak, that Mission Foods trophy. What do we have to do to turn this into a gold man tomorrow?
Hey, we just got to keep working right there. We wanted to run a little bit better, but not shoot ourselves in the foot. And, hey, I got off. I thought it was going to be a little bit better on the tree. We were dead even with Shawn. And something happened to him, fizzled out. But we got the win from Matco Tools, Lucas Oil, Hanksford's FEP, Toyota, Sirius XM, all of our great partners that make this happen, Summit Racing. You know, Mission, thank you for putting it on. And I guess our tortilla chips fell in the right place. So we got a little bit lucky. Got to be there to get lucky. And we're feeling good. Brian Karate, all these guys, been and Mark Oswald, Brad Mates, they've been working hard, man. And we just got to keep getting better. We got progress going, and we're going to get after it tomorrow.